Wherever you are, want to raise up the banner of Jesus Christ through intercession. Call upon the name of Jesus Christ.
Every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that truly Jesus is the Lord and God of our lives today. The name Jesus Christ, we call upon that name. That is the name that we call upon today. For thy word says, be highly exalted, be highly exalted, be highly exalted, mighty Redeemer. Be highly exalted, King of Glory. Be highly exalted, Master Jesus. This is not the time for us as Christians to keep silent. This is not the time for us as Christians to watch things happen. But it's our time to take up our position. It's the time to take up our position and declare that salvation has come today in our lives. Salvation has come today in our countries. Salvation has come today to the world. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. We bless you and we worship you, King of Glory.
Jesus, you are Yahweh.
Us today on our social media platform. My name is Reverend Justus Olaju, Senior Pastor of this church, Apostolic Church Revival Center. And I want us to pray, and thereafter we welcome reading of the scripture, and we shall be going through as the Holy Ghost will be able to guide us. Father, in the name of Jesus, I commit my dear viewer unto thy gracious hands, unto thy divine hands today, that as we fellowship together through the media, Jehovah Lord, you will touch your people, your children, from wherever they are following us from. But whatever needs that they have, Jehovah Lord, as they lift up their needs unto you, Jesus Christ, you are going to minister unto their needs. Minister unto their lives, O King of Glory. We pray for all our members from wherever they are following us. We pray for all our viewers across the country and across the globe, that Jehovah Lord, as we walk through the word of God today, you shall become a blessing. You shall become the bread of life unto the children of God. We thank you and we bless you, for it is in Jesus' name we pray, trusting and believing. Amen. I hereby welcome our brother Arthur to read our text today from the book of Luke, chapter number 15, verse number 7, and then you will jump and read verse number 10.
Amen. I'm reading the book of Luke, chapter number 15, verse 7, and the Bible says, I say to you that likewise joy shall be in heaven over one sinner that repents, more than over 90 just person which need no repentance. Verse number 10 says, Likewise, I say to you, there is joy in the presence of the angels of God over one sinner that repents. And that's the word of God.
Thank you. My dear viewer, once again, I want to thank you for choosing to fellowship with us today on this media platform. Today, we are looking at the results of repentance. And maybe somebody is asking, why have this pastor chosen to talk about repentance? We have just come from Easter. And we need to understand the real meaning as to why the Lord, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, chose to die at the cross of Calvary, and why he overcame death. And we have been talking in our previous Sundays, we have been talking about what is repentance, and we also talked about the processes of genuine repentance. That was last Sunday. And today we want to see what are the results of genuine repentance. From the passage of scripture that we have read, the Bible talks about what happens when one person, when one sinner repents of his sin. And Jesus said, I say to you that likewise joy shall be in heaven over one sinner that repents, more than over 99 just persons which need no repentance. In other words, God and heaven is so concerned about one person out of 100 that repents than 99 who have no reason to repent. Now, one result number one of genuine repentance, I call it great joy. There is joy and there is great joy. And more so, in this context, we are talking about great joy in heaven. For example, when the prodigal son repented, the Bible says there was rejoicing, as recorded in the book of Luke, chapter number 15, verse 23. The father said, bring here the fattened calf and kill it, and let us eat and be merry. In other words, even in that family of the prodigal son, they rejoiced together. Now, it is important, my dear viewer, that result number one for genuine repentance is great joy. All of heaven rejoices when one sinner repents, knowing that God gives us forgiveness of sins to all who confess, openly brings us humankind unto the place of joy. It brings us unto great joy, knowing that God forgives all those that confess openly their sins. In the book of Acts, chapter number 8, the Bible records verse 5 that when the Samaritans listened to the preaching of Philip, there was great joy in the city. I came to tell our viewers today that the preaching of the word of God brings great joy to the people who chooses to repent of their sins. Because when we genuinely repent of our sins, guilt goes through the window. The anguish disappears. And we become so joyful unto God because there is hope. Praise be to the Lord. The result number two today is the new birth. And now this is very critical, my dear viewers. There is new birth after genuine repentance. And we are talking about new birth experience. There are two elements of birth experiences. There is birth of water and birth of the spirit. When a sinner repents of his or her sin, that old sinful nature is dead. A and the believer is ready for the new birth. In other words, Jesus Christ died on the cross of Calvary, and after death, he was buried, and he resurrected. So I'm talking about the new birth experience. When you have repented of your sins, result number one, there is great joy. And result number 2A, there must be the birth experience of water. Jesus said to Nicodemus, except a man be born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God. My dear viewers, I don't want you to marvel the same way Nicodemus marveled. And saying, as old as I am, can I enter back into the womb of my mother and be born again? And Jesus said, that which born of the flesh will remain the flesh, but that which is born of the Spirit shall become of the Spirit. And today I came to tell us, as recorded in the book of John chapter 3 verse 5, except you be born again of the water and of the Spirit, you cannot enter into the kingdom of God. You must realize these are direct translation, direct quotation of the Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ. And he used the word except, which means you have no choice. You have no any other choice. You must be born again of the water and of the Spirit for you to enter into the kingdom of God. My dear viewers, repentance is the seed from which the new birth experience stems from. Repentance is the seed. Without repentance, no water baptism. Water baptism means being buried. When we repent of our sins, we are dying out of the old nature. And naturally, following a death, there must be a burial. The old sinful man must be put away. Therefore, we are buried with him through baptism into his death, as recorded in the book of Romans, chapter number 6 and verse 4. Water baptism is a type of the burial of our sins. After genuine repentance, you have died to your sins, my dear viewer. And there must be the next step. You must move to the next phase of being buried. Your old nature must be buried. In Colossians chapter 2 verse 12, repentance must be followed by water baptism. This water baptism is in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, for the remission of our sins, as recorded in the book of Acts chapter number 2, verse number 38. When they heard Peter preaching the word of God and declaring the power of the risen Christ, Bible saying they were pricked in their hearts. And they asked Peter, what must we do in order to be saved? And Peter told them, repent of your sins, every one of you, and be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of your sins. Hear me, my dear viewers. You should not tarry. Once you have repented of your sins, you must arise and be baptized. You must wash away of your sins, calling upon the name of the Lord. Because it is only the name of the Lord that has been given power and authority to forgive our sins. As recorded in Acts chapter number 22, verse number 16. Why and now, why tarriest thou, King James Version? Arise and be baptized and wash away thy sins, calling upon the name of the Lord. My dear viewers, from wherever you are following us from, that the new birth must follow repentance. It is a result of genuine repentance. Praise be to the Lord. The other thing that I'm going to speak about is total cleansing. Total cleansing. I have jumped part 2 of new birth. of the Holy Spirit. Let me give you the third one, total cleansing. Jesus said, if we walk in the light as he is in the light, then we must have fellowship one with another. And the blood of Jesus Christ will cleanse us from all sin. As recorded in 1 John 1 verse 7. My dear viewers, when we repent of our sins, there is total cleansing. We begin to walk in the newness of life. We become into fellowship with our Lord and Savior. Because we have been washed by the blood of Jesus Christ, which was shed at the cross of Calvary. I came to tell us, my dear viewers, that Easter, the whole meaning of the risen Christ after Easter, on an Easter Sunday, is that the blood of Jesus has washed all our sins. And we have risen in the newness of life. When God cleanses us from all our sins, we are totally clean. It is as though we have never committed sin. As far as the east is from the west, says David in Psalms 103, verse 12. As far as the east is from the west, so far has he removed our transgressions from us. Praise be to the Lord. When we repent of our sins, my dear viewer, hear me. As far as the east is from the west, the same way the Lord has removed our sins far away from us. Genuine repentance will cause a total cleansing by the blood of Jesus. Praise be to the Lord. And therefore, as I said earlier, repentance is the seed from which the new birth experience stems from. There can never be total cleansing if there is no genuine repentance. It is important, my dear viewer. Number four, there is restitution. After cleansing, there is restitution. Restitution is an important part. It is an integral part of repentance, my dear viewer. True repentance will produce restitution. And I'm using the example of Zacchaeus. Zacchaeus, as recorded in the book of Luke, chapter 19, verse 8, he agreed to return all that he had robbed or stolen from the people. And he said, if I had wrongly taken something from somebody, I will return. And not only return what I had taken, but I will bring double or even three times. My dear viewers, the simplest definition of the word restitution simply means the right of giving back to the rightful owner. Giving of something as an equivalent of equal value for what has been lost or damaged. Praise be to the Lord. Webster's Encyclopedia Dictionary simply defines restitution as the right of giving back to the rightful one. You had taken it from somebody who rightfully owns it. And because you have repented, if you want to receive godly restitution, then you must return what you took away from the rightful owner. And if you live in this country, you will understand. I am sure somebody is guessing what I'm about to mention. Many people have taken properties, land, that do not belong to them. But sometimes the government moves in and they return that land to the rightful owner. We have even seen people who had built malls, even in the public land, being taken back and malls being demolished. And the land is taken back to the government. That is the best example of restitution. Zacchaeus repented. You return and ask for forgiveness. Asking for forgiveness is the most painful thing for any human being to do. Because you feel embarrassed, you feel degraded. For you to ask for forgiveness. But restitution demands that you must be willing to ask for forgiveness. And if we are going to allow godly restitution to apply in our life, then we must be willing to go through the price of true repentance. The repentant person must change. He not only says he's sorry, he did wrong, he also stops doing wrong again. That's why I said it is expensive. Guilt and condemnation are heavy weights to carry around as a believer. Guilt makes one feel ugly. Guilt makes a believer feel unhappy. It makes you as a person to feel lonely and hateful in your heart. I want to give you an example. If I gave you this Bible to carry throughout your life, as light as it may appear to be, from my natural weight scale skills, I think it is about 1 kg. As light as it may appear to be, if you were to carry it throughout your life, from Monday to Sunday, from January to December, I can tell you, this Bible will weigh you down. At some point, you will feel, I am overburdened. You will put it down. My dear view, I came to tell you, sin can weigh you down. Sin can make you to give up in life. But I want to encourage us that when we repent of our sins, our life becomes easier. But as long as you remain with it, I came to declare to us, you will feel overburdened. It will become heavier in your life. And I want to tell you, my dear viewer, that finally, the other result of repentance is being baptized, receiving baptism of the Holy Spirit. According to Romans chapter 6, baptism of the Holy Spirit is a type of the resurrection of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Jesus tells us in John 14 verse 7 that the world cannot receive this kind of experience. What Jesus was meaning, what he meant, was that those that are unwilling to give up their carnal ways and things of the world through repentance cannot receive this wonderful gift from our Lord. A person cannot receive the Holy Ghost before repentance. Hear me clearly, my dear viewer. Nowhere in the Bible, nowhere, and I stand to be corrected, was anybody filled in the New Testament, filled with the Holy Ghost before repentance? Repentance is an integral part of our salvation. When we repent, you are pardoned of your sin, and you are able to commune with God. And once you receive forgiveness of sins, God can fill you with the Holy Ghost. And even baptism, water baptism, can follow later. But never has it been recorded in the Bible where somebody received the Holy Ghost before water, before repentance. Repentance changes us. Repentance makes us complete the new birth experience. When we receive the Holy Ghost, it is a confirmation that indeed you have repented. The infilling of the Holy Ghost is a confirmation that God has accepted you. The Holy Ghost makes you to become a new creature in Christ Jesus. And as I close, my dear viewer, as recorded in the book of Ezekiel, chapter number 36, verse 26 and 27. A new heart also will I give you, and a new spirit will I put within you, and I will take away the stony heart out of your flesh, and cause you to walk in my statutes, and you shall keep my judgments and do them. The Holy Spirit is promised to all who obey the word of God and go through that genuine repentance. Simply repent and claim God's promise unto your life after forgiveness. Your burdens will begin to lift as you confess your sins before God, and you start to feel His love and mercy. My dear viewer, a natural response to this feeling is to begin to worship God. Many times when somebody has repented, joy begins to flow in his or her spirit, and you will see that person lifting up his or her hands and begin to worship God. My dear viewer, allow me to submit you to you this last issues that have come out of results of repentance. When you repent, you are released from sin. When you repent, there is excitement after genuine repentance. There is peace in the Lord after genuine repentance. There is great desire to know God's word after genuine repentance. You become new in all aspects. In other words, you become a new person in all your dealings with people and with God. You are accepted before Him. Before the eyes of God, you become accepted. I want to pray with you, my dear viewer. You acquire new power in the Lord Jesus after genuine repentance. So the result of repentance, my dear viewer, you get great joy, you get the new birth experience, birth of water, a new birth of the Holy Ghost, you get total cleansing, and you get restitution. And I want to pray with us today that after the risen Christ, after celebrating the Easter Sunday, rejoicing in the resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, I want you to begin to walk a new path in Christ Jesus. From wherever you are, I want to tell you, after COVID-19, call us on our number. Call us on our number that we can take you through. We are willing to work with you, my dear sister, my dear brother. And I want to pray with you from wherever you are following us. Even if you have been born again of the water, you still need to be born again of the Spirit. Because Jesus said in John 3:5, unless you are born again of the Spirit, of the water and of the Spirit, you can never enter into the kingdom. It is the will of God, my dear viewer, that you inherit the kingdom of God. It is the will of God that you inherit the kingdom of God. Because in the kingdom of God, there are many mansions, Jesus said. He has got to prepare a mansion for you, my sister. There is a mansion for you, my brother. There is a mansion for you, a servant of God. There is a mansion for each one of us. I want to inherit my mansion in the kingdom of God. Let us bow our heads as we pray from wherever you are following us. My dear viewer, once again, there is a number scrolling down the screen. Reach us through that number, and we can pray with you. We can speak to you. We can walk you through the word of God. And we can arrange on how we are even going to baptize you. Because right behind here, there is a baptistry, and I'll be speaking about it come next Sunday, how you need to be baptized. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for my dear viewer, wherever they are following us from. Somebody has been living in sin. Lord, I pray today in the name of Jesus that you are forgiving that sin. Wipe those tears, my Lord. Give them the newness of mind, newness of heart. They can begin to walk in the newness of life in Christ Jesus. Bring some hope, O my Savior. May you be known, Lord God of heaven. I pray today, somebody was about to give up, but Lord, you are full of grace, full of favor. name of the Lord. Touch that sister wherever she is. Touch that brother in the name of the Lord. That you can encourage them, Lord. Because they are good results of repentance. That they can receive total cleansing. That they can receive God restitution. That they can receive the new birth. That they can begin to experience the great joy of the Lord after total repentance. Lord, I thank you. Even as I pray that you will protect the land of Kenya. Protect the leadership of this country. Protect all the religious people, oh God. Give them the courage to keep us going in faith. This is the time, Lord, that we need to join our hearts together and prepare our people that they can believe God even more than before at such a time like this. Because in due season, the Lord shall manifest himself. He's a kind of a God who is willing to hear our cries only after genuine repentance. I thank you, Lord, and I bless you. For it is in Jesus' name I pray, trusting and believing. May God's people from wherever you are say amen. May God bless you. May God of hosts cleanse your soul and bring joy in your spirit, that you may begin to walk in the newness of life. Make a decision and call us. Reach us, because we are waiting to hear from you, that we may be able to rejoice the Lord together with you as you go through the new birth experience. May the Lord keep you and bless you till next Sunday, in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Amen.